We had heard about the New World Festival for years, but my wife and I are traveling musicians, so last year we get to come for the first time and are resolved to never miss another one. We like to see the Canadian culture, the music that's still going on up there, come into Randolph, Vermont. And we both have a love for French Canadian music as well. So I think it's just neat to have some of this roots music right here in Vermont for us to be able to partake in.
Hi, I'm Ray Greenleaf with Vermont Celta Company from Mendon, Vermont. And we're here at the New World Festival at the Chandler Music Hall, Center for the Arts in Randolph, Vermont, having a great time. One of the first things I noticed while I was setting up the shop, was I had a group of kids practicing songs over here, and they're all laughing and joking and having a good time. And really their introduction to the arts at a young age that they'll carry through their whole lives. And that was my first impression of the New World Festival here, and I think that's really great.
Hello, my name is Patrick Sharp.
I'm Kyla Skeet Browning.
And I'm Sophie Rowe.
And we're the Moor Road Fiddlers. We've all been coming here for a long time.
Yeah, like
maybe, I was 8 or 9, so many years.
Yeah,
annual
I think
tradition.
So too. Mm-hmm. Exactly, like part of it is like getting to meet really like lots of other musicians and be in an environment where it's just like constant music. And
yeah, and like once you're done playing, you can just go relax and watch everybody mm-hmm. else, which is always good.
Yeah, watching people is also really nice.
Last year when we came in here, we got to see 10 strings and a goat skin, and as soon as the fiddle started, we felt like the paint was coming off the walls. So we have 6 children, we love to bring them here, and the spirit's good, the people are good, it's a real special festival.
So we're here at 10 Strings and the Goatskin. We come from Prince Edward Island, Canada, and we're here to play you some musics. So this is a little set called Mick and Dave's, after the guys who taught us the first tune. So that's not very inventive at all, is it? Anyway, hope you guys enjoy. Thank you. song. It's about a young English soldier who gets on a boat. He joins the Royal Army, and he gets on a boat, and he travels across the wild Atlantic to North America to fight the French and the Huron in the Seven Years' War, or the French-Indian War, as you guys probably know down here. So what happens is that he gets shot, and that's no good.
Setting this up to be a real serious song.
Yeah, I was. Anyway, no. So he is mortally wounded on the field of battle, and this song, in fact, is his letter that he writes home to his family, telling them that he's just kind of very confused. He doesn't know where he is. He doesn't know who he's fighting or for what he's fighting for, and he's telling his big brother to look out for his family. So it's it's starting to set off on a. That's real depressing, but that being said, it's a beautiful tune, so hope you guys know. This is called The Uniform.
If I could just get a little more of that, please. And hit about 40 men or so. Those poor souls, they feel them bleeding, stained in white snow. Soon they fired their second volley, and a lead bomb pierced my breast. I fell down upon my knees, I was gasping for a breath. Soon I had awoke, found myself laying on my back. Found a firing line of bloody surgeons by. So I write to you in this letter. Ring a battle in my ears, just a poor fear. I will have no hero's death. To me, that much is clear. This uniform grows heavy on my body.
Kind of bilingual education settings, so we all do the Franco-Anglo thing, and we're gonna perform for you a French number from the west coast of Brittany. Oh no, west coast of France. The province is Brittany, and yeah, so it's kind of one of the seven the Celtic nations. And while we were touring in France this year, we played Brittany and we played this song for them. They all seemed to really like it. It was made really popular back in the 1970s by a group called Trien, who were like kind of a... Really? Oh! You're literally the first person in North America that we have met. We'll meet you afterwards. Anyway, yeah, no, so Trien are a fantastic, fantastic kind of like... They were like kind of a psychedelic traditional Breton music, and they were all sorts of weird, but they made great music, and in the end we were touring in Brittany, we passed through, and everyone really liked the song. It was very well known, and then we went to the south of France after we were on the coast, and we're like, oh, the southerners, you know, they if the Brittany people like this, then they'll love it, you know, because they don't know anything about this stuff. And then we played a festival. It was kind of like a Celtic music festival, and right in the south of France, where there shouldn't have been like any ties at all. And we were all bloaty. We were on our high horses for this one, and we presented it, and we're like, yeah. And we did exactly that intro, and we're like, yeah. And Trien, they're a bunch of crazy old guys, and they all, you know, really psychedelic and just weird music and stuff like this. And I mean, we were trying to be polite. It didn't quite work, and it turns out that the band following us was Trien. We were like, so
well, they were closing out the night anyway. Yeah, so
so we were just like, we just got in the band right afterwards and left. Yeah. So anyway, so this is a tune called Malibon Lurette, and it's about a young man who goes off and he tries to find a wife. And it's possible he does it in the creepiest way imaginable. He just goes into town and picks one, kind of points at her, and then runs at her. And I mean, I don't think that would work no matter what century you were born in. So. Anyway, this is called Malheureux du Gâteau. Hope you guys enjoy.
Sois marié, mal, je n'avais rien à faire, mal, 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 chercher mal, 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 chercher mal, I'm
Just starting to make history. The three folks on stage have been making musical history for a long time. A couple of members of La Banquine, Soriante, and Les Charbonnières d'Enfer. It's very honored to New World Festival to welcome Le Bruit Court dans la Vie.
Thank you.
For a real treat. Let's give a great New World Festival welcome to Fretless.
I feel like Vermont music, I really feel like Forked Deer is, it really epitomizes it. So naturally, I was like, I think we should play this tune. And so these guys are like, great. You don't get to play for like the first 2 minutes though.
It's my favorite start of the tune, personally.
It's the most in tune I play in the concert. Thank you.
it's nice to be part of so many of this festival where we're just kind of like wandering around from awesome piece of band music to another band that's playing another cool thing, and then you open another door and there's a band playing something cool over there. You guys found that today too? Happy meanders. We're gonna do a tune here that I wrote in the month of June. And at the time it was new, so I called it Trent's New June Tune. And then it's not new anymore, and these guys know my name, so it's just called the June Tune. Thank you.